Hi, this is Bird from Bird's SVGs, and in this video I'll be showing you how I put my egg books together. And this is from the Nature's Bounty SVG collection. And this box holds 6 chicken eggs. Around the outside of my box I have these pieces that are decoration pieces mainly, but they do add some extra sturdiness to your box. But these make it look like it's a little mini crate, like a little, you know, vegetable crate. So what I'm doing is I'm adding some distress ink to the edges of my pieces. And on these, what will be corner pieces, they've got a little score line down the centre. So I'm folding along the edge of that line and I'm adding some distress ink along there as well, because that's going to be the corner of my boxes. So you just need to add it to all the edges of the other pieces. But on these 4 in particular, it will finish it off nicely if you fold them in half and add some distress ink. And the one I've used for this one is frayed burlap. I've actually used some wood grain effect pattern paper from the Homestead kit that I used. But I think even if you use plain brown cardstock, if you ink the edges, not only will it make it look a little bit like weathered wood, but it adds some definition to the edges of your pieces. So where they overlap, you can kind of see the design a bit better. So I'm going to work on the insert of my egg box in a moment, but first of all I'm going to start on the structure of the box itself. Now this is cut in different colour paper to your outside pieces, so that way the pieces that form kind of the wooden crate look, they stand out against this. So first of all, we need to add some glue to the end tabs and close these pieces up. These will form the sides of my box. Just making sure the top's flush there. Then I'll add glue to the other tab and close it up. And then I can add some glue to the bottom tabs and add the base to my box. And the base is the slightly larger of the two pieces. And then the slightly smaller of the two pieces goes on the inside, and that sandwiches the tabs together. So it adds some structure to the bottom of the box, but it also hides the tabs in there. So it makes it nice and neat on the inside. Now the reason I thought this egg box would be a good idea is that we have chickens at home. We have had for many years now. And there is certain times where you have too many eggs, you just can't get through them yourself. And you might want to gift them to friends and family. And instead of saving your old supermarket egg boxes to put them in like we used to, I thought, wouldn't it be nice if you had a bit of a decorative little box to put them in, because after all, when you've got your own chickens, you kind of feel that your eggs are quite special. So have your box, you know, reflect the specialness of your eggs. Okay, this is the insert that goes inside, and this is where the eggs themselves sit. So you can fold along all of your sides. There's no gluing to be done on that. They just fold down. This is a duplicate layer for the top of that piece. And it's just to add a little bit of strength. So just add some glue and then pop it over the layer, over your insert there. Just line up the holes and it'll be in place. So to pop this insert into the box, all you need to do is fold the sides down, slide it into your box, and then the sides actually just kind of cling to the corners inside. So there's no gluing or anything to be done. Okay, so we're just going to add the decorative panels to the outside of the box, and you should see that these are quite easy to place. You've got your 2 longer sides, your 2 shorter sides, and then you have the 4 little corner pieces that are like little uprights. So when I distressed my pieces with my distress ink, You can use any ink, actually, especially a water-based ink, because the pigment ones, they tend not to dry very quickly. But I actually added some ink to the top and bottom and the insert, the cutout sections, but I didn't add any to the sides because the little corner pieces are going to cover the sides up. And then what you'll also see in my finished example is that I added some enamel dots, and I added them as though they were kind of like nails or rivets in the box. Alternatively, you could use brads. I think that would look really cool too. Okay, so I'm just adding some glue to each of these four pieces, and they just butt up to the corner of the box. And as you see, they cover over those sides of the panel, so you don't need to distress those sides. Just add the last one into place. And there you can see all four sides. So this insert, you just fold the sides, slide it in, and the bottom edge of those sides just rest against the bottom of your crate. So it'll be about an inch up from the bottom, and it's enough clearance for your eggs to sit inside. Okay, I've got a little label to go on the front of your box, and it's a little chicken to kind of reflect what's inside your box. So I'm just adding some glue onto this, way more than I actually need. You only need to add a little bit. And I'm just popping that onto some cream card so the design stands out. You can glue your little chicken to the front of your box, or I'm just going to add some 3D foam pads. These are some quite shallow ones, so it won't stick out too much. I'm just going to add a couple of those onto the back of my label. I remove my backing and pop that into place. Okay, so now we're going to move on to the acetate insert for the box. I hope you can see it there. You can see some light reflecting off it. So you just want to fold along all of these score lines. Oh, and it's worth mentioning that the acetate that I used was, because the acetate that I've been using recently, it doesn't state on it the weight. So I did actually get this acetate. I ordered some 220 micron, just so you know the kind of weight that I'm using. This is actually a little bit thinner than the acetate that I've been using recently, but it still is a good construction weight. So it's heavy enough to make your boxes and your cards and things like that, as well as using them for, you know, shaker cards and such. So I folded along all of my score lines on my acetate, and then I'm adding some strong double-sided sticky tape to the four tabs. Now this is the same type of tape as red liner tape. It's just mine happens to have a yellow liner on it, but it's that same super sticky clear tape. Okay, so I'm removing the liner from one side at a time, and then you just want to line up the corner of your box, and I'm just squeezing the tab into place, making sure that, you know, that I put a little bit of pressure along the length of the tape to make sure it's, you know, it has a connection. There, it's as simple as that to make your acetate insert. Now you slide that inside your box, and just as the insert of the box rests against the bottom of the box, the acetate liner rests against your insert. So it rests like halfway down, so it's perfectly level across the top of your box. That way you can add a ribbon around it, if you like to make it more secure.